Oh yeah, and all respect be to the Smelt master. Lovely time of year. It's springtime, which means it's almost time for thaw, which also means it's time for Maypole festivities. So welcome and let's play together around the Maypole. If you encounter a moose while in the wild in Minnetonka, the recommended way to make sure you have a happy interaction with Mr. Moose is to speak to him in his own language. So first, you must not be a threat. So Mr. Chicky Finn, I know you'll like this because you enjoy hand motions and it's involved. Are you ready? Now, if the moose tries to charge you, the best thing to do is lay flat on the ground and make a sound like this. Now, that may take some practice. However, once you've heard it up close, you don't forget it. It's real exciting that you're here now, Mr. Chicky Finn, because it's Maypole time. What we're celebrating with the Maypole is how many of our children actually survived the winter. We get real excited. If we've got, you know, a dozen and a half left over, well, you know, that's a big year. So you might hear some children laughing in the background. You know, they're happy because they survived, you know, and that's real important. We like to teach our children about life and death real young out here in Minnetonka. You know, it's important that they understand, you know, that they might not make it through the winter. So, you know, if you haven't ridden your bike or something, you better do it now. We've elected you to be the Smelt master this year. It's a real big honor. We're going to dub you the Smelt master, all right? And it means you get to wear the very, very special Smelt master's crown. It is my honor to dub you Chicky Finn. And now we are ready. So how it works is I'm going to start a dance around the Maypole. Traditionally, the woman goes first, and you'll follow along with your own dance behind me. This represents the union of man and woman to create children. Now, what will happen is I will throw in a very ceremonial manner, like so, the smelt behind me, where your job is to catch them. Today, one of our favorite love potions, as we like to call them here in Minnetonka, it's called a glacier mist. To make a glacier mist, you'll need 3/4 of an ounce of vodka, 3/4 of an ounce blue curacao liqueur. Oh, that's fancy. 1 ounce of lime juice, 2 ounces of soda water, and 2 ounces of lemon lime soda. Glaciery. Now, Mr. Chicky Finn, you've done a wonderful job of catching a smelt for us this year. You know, once they're all nicely coated in the flour, what you want to do, because, you know, this is very ceremonial for us here in Minnetonka, what you want to do is count them up. So we're going to count and see what the estimates are for our children in the thaw. Here's little Emma. One here's Cleo, a baby Smith. Cindy, here's little Mary Lou. Oh my goodness, little Susie, Philip, Hunter, one Riley, he's real tall, I don't know. Chelsea, Robert, Amanda, Timon, Joanne. Look, now I see who's standing over there in the corner. Now don't worry about a thing there, little Bobby, we've got you right here. Teresa, Lori, Billy, Mitchell, Andrew, Andy right there. Names, Mr. Chicky Finn. Sometimes the children get real upset. That's all I'm saying. So, once you have several fish in your pan, you want to let them cook until they're nice and golden brown on one side, and then you can flip them right over, and they'll be nice and golden brown on the other side. Once your smelt are done, and while they're still nice and warm, you want to give them a nice squeeze of lemon, just like this. Smell delicious. Now, once you have your smelt ready, you're going to want to put it somewhere where it'll stay warm. Well, you'll work on your cauliflower. What you want to do is boil your cauliflower till it's nice and soft, so that a knife passes cleanly through without much effort. Then, you're going to want to add about a half a stick of butter. You want to add a generous amount of pepper. Next, you want to add some salt, maybe about half a teaspoon. Then, the special ingredient, horseradish. You'll want to mash your cauliflower until it's completely soft. You don't want to see any bits and pieces if you can make them all go away. Now our meal is ready, and it's time to have our wonderful maple celebration meal. So we start by putting a couple of smelt on the plate, just like that, real nice. A nice healthy serving of our cauliflower. And I like to make a lovely salad with some goat cheese. Mr. Chicky Finn, I have a story to tell you. You seem like a man of the world, and I think that you, more than anyone, will understand. I must admit, Mr. Chicky Finn, it's been rough, you know. I personally have experienced a heartbreak, but I feel like you're a real close friend of mine now, you know. Well, you know, Mr. Chicky Finn, I got involved with a man, you know, and we were together for a good while. You know, and you know, I thought it was love, you know, as a girl does, you know, she gives her heart and soul. It's just, you know, in the bedroom, you know, those, that rack, you know, the moose rack was so heavy, it chafed beneath, you know, here beneath the chin, and it made the noises, you know, I made the noises for you, you know, poof. You know, Mohorn, yeah, I'm talking to you. And I did everything that you wanted me to do, you know, until the rack started sliding off my head. And I wound up in the emergency room. You know, Mr. Chicky Finn, I had to make up a story and lie to the doctors and nurses there in the emergency room. I mean, how do you explain, you know, rack marks, you know, when it's falling off? and you've got strap marks, you know, on your neck, Mr. Chicky Finn. How do you explain that? How do you explain that, Booth? But you know, you men are all the same.
Look at that. What? The cameraman
there
is winking
a,
at you.
Oh, he's cute. Hey. Hey. Wow. Cheers.
Cheers. So we'll see if we can get you a date with one of the crew.
Fine, Booth Mahorn. I know.
Don't you think that cameraman's kind of cute?
It was all about your timing every time.
He's winking at you right there.
Oh, no, no. Fine, I tolerated it when you wanted to wear your wool hat.
That's all we have. That's all the time we have.
And then I was being
It's time for dish and a drink to be on its way to the next city.
Under the pillow.
To where you live.
It leaves a mark on the forehead, a hunting rifle. That's what I'm telling you, Booth.
So, until next time.
Sure, how much is a girl supposed to do?
Cheers.
Ouch. Oh, I dropped my berries. What? Mr. Chicky Finn, speaking of berries, I can see right up your shorts. POTATOE. Potato.